So hello, I'm Christophe. You are the Braves who kind of skip the dessert of the lunch. So you'll get an extra award from, you get a reduction on your in your fee of MIP next year. No, sure not. They're not that generous. Okay, so I'm Christophe. I'm a former broadcaster in different places in Europe. And for the fourth time, I'm very happy to host this pitching competition. It's been held the last 3 years, and some of the winners or the participants already are in production or produced, so it's really useful. The winners actually get quite a lot of exposure, a lot of contacts with different broadcasters, people with a lot of money, so it's really useful. And I help them a little bit because I'm not just a former broadcaster, I'm also a consultant on content and strategy, and I'm also a farmer, which is not very useful for this purpose. So, this year, what is really, really special is that a nice country, because the initial of this country means water. The EAU in French means water, eau. So they don't have much, but they have oil and they have money. So a big company from these places, from Abu Dhabi, decided to sponsor it. So, and they also did a great job, because they're a big company. They'll tell you a bit about what they do. But they were also the jury of the selection from the 130 projects. Usually the jury, I was part of it, and it was taking all the August month away from the beach, which was very annoying. So they did the job this year. So welcome with me from Majid, Mohamed Yeha, the CEO, the managing director, Ivan Doncic, who is the head of of digital, and Afra Al-Khashti, who is the media director. They're the fantastic jury, so most of them will sit here, and if you've never been to Abu Dhabi, you should go, it's a fantastic place. And we'll first ask to Mohamed a little bit about Majid.
That's a turn.
Thanks a lot for sponsoring, for being here, for doing all the hard work of selections.
We're really happy to be here, and we'd like to introduce briefly Majid Entertainment, the subsidiary of Abu Dhabi Media, but I'd also like to introduce my colleagues, Mrs. Afra Rashidi, she's the head of Media Division and Cultural Affairs, and Mr. Ivan Doncic, he's the head of the Digital Media and Digital Media and Online Strategies. So, very briefly, Majid as a brand, was founded in 1979. Majid started as a kids magazine, widely known across the Arab-speaking world, and after almost 40 years, it was transformed into a TV channel. We launched the channel last week on the 25th of September.
So they are very exhausted.
we are really tired.
It's a huge brand. I mean, for you to know, I mean, it's like a classic brand. For mainly Arabic-speaking people, they know Majid, just for you to know, are not Arabic-speaking.
Majid as a brand has a special place in the heart of mind of those who grew up in the 1980s and 1990s, and as such has won the trust and respect of children and parents alike throughout the Middle East. Today, Majid Kids TV aims to bring the same energy and the same magic to the current generation, adapting its approach to include contemporary platform of communication, including digital media and gaming. And this opportunity also, I would like to make a special announcement. By sponsoring this year's event, we have been thrilled to receive an extraordinary amount of high-quality proposals filled with wonderful creative idea, and that's what we have decided to sponsor this unique event for the next 3 years and establish a long-lasting
Hallelujah.
Relationship with some of the leading creatives.
So we are sure that there will be other pitching competition, and it will be well-financed, and they will continue to work. Thank you very much.
We will support the new ideas. We will support the creative concept. We will support financially, and we'll support, we can co-produce. Just keep the good work going, and we are here to help you.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. How should I say that in Arabic? Thanks. Shukran. Shukran. I knew that. Sorry. Shukran. So this is the fantastic jury. So now we'll have the five contestants, the five nominees, the five winners of the final. The rules are quite strict. They have 5 minutes to tell about their shows. And I remember some people trying to extend the 5 minutes. No, I'm half German. It will be 5 minutes. And then there'll be 3 minutes of Q&As with the jury and me. And obviously, positive questions to make sure we understood everything and things are clear for everyone. And then they will choose one winner. We'll get all this big exposure here during MIPJunior and MIPCOM. And that's it. I don't know if I forgot something, Mohamed. No, I
think basically that's
we're cool. Okay, so we'll officially start now. And we'll start first with a project from Mexico. So please welcome with me from the Mighty Animation, the CEO Claudio Jimenez for Juan Football. Thank you very much for being here. Good luck. And as soon, no, don't start the clock now. I'm talking, he's not. Every second, thank you. So good luck, and thank you very much for being here.
Okay, 5 minutes, okay. Hi, I'm Claudio, I come from Mexico. And there is two things Mexicans love the most. There is tequila, and there is football. So who here likes football? Oh, a few hands. I was expecting a little bit more. So let me tell you about Juan Football. When we started creating Juan Football, we never thought of it being a traditional TV series. We thought about it being more like a transmedia project for our target audience that are kids 8 to 35. Basically, all internet and social network users. So making short Twitter-style formats, content, that are fast, that are dynamic, and that are funny. 1 minute, 2 minute clips for Facebook and YouTube, 6 second clips for Vines, Instagram, and other content such as memes, emojis, GIFs, anything that can be shared, retweeted, and forward. So, who is Juan? As the slogan says, we're all Juan Football. Juan is a player, he's a coach, he's a referee, he's a soccer fan, he's your father, he's your girlfriend, he's all of you that didn't raise your hands. And he's a satire of the love and passion that is a strange love and passion that we all have for football. So we designed these little green grass patches that we made them funny, we made them crazy, and we made them friendly. Basically, they were born Mexican. In conclusion, Juan Football is when we troll Bladder throwing money at him. Juan Football is when I gather with my friends to watch the match. And I'm Juan Football when I'm trying to make an awesome penalty.
Ricardo Ferretti, la incongruencia apareció porque después de criticar los partidos moleros,
so he actually made the goal at the end, right? So we launched Juan Football this year, mid-July, with our first clip introducing the character. And it did pretty well for being the first one. It had over 100,000 views. Next month, we launched the second clip. And this one did a little bit better. It had over 300,000 views. And last week, this Saturday, we launched the third one, going over 500,000 views. So people in Mexico are getting to know more of the character and their adventures, and we're generating more content for the social networks, emojis, memes, everything, so that our users that are already watching the content can start to interact more with the product. So what's next for Juan Football? We're launching 3 more clips by the end of the year. And our goal is to keep making fun content for Juan that can be shared all over the world, not only in Mexico, and at some point get Juan Football little adventures on TV. Thank you.
Gracias, congratulations. So questions from the jury first, Q&As, or if you want, I mean, yeah, you can ask.
Hello.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for showcasing that. It's quite funny. My first question has to do with the similarities with something else. Do you think that this might have any similarities with SpongeBob as a character, the look? Because that came to my mind, first of all. And especially when you spoke about digital assets, do you get those comments online?
We haven't get any relation to SpongeBob. I guess he's square.
It's square, yes.
He's square and he has eyes. No, we haven't yet, but I guess bringing that up, that would be something to look at, definitely.
My question also relates to merchandising in the future, whether there is copywriting or anything else related to that.
Definitely. We would definitely look onto that.
But it is green and it's square and it has tits. That's very different from SpongeBob. SpongeBob has holes.
Yeah, and SpongeBob has tits. A nose, right? A big nose, I guess. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much. The only question that I have is, do you think the football will limit your audience? Like it will exclude the girls, for example, since it's a football?
Actually, we're planning for the future clips. There will be more girls introduced, like Juan Football's girlfriend. It's the same Juan Football, but with hair, and she's dressed as a woman with necklace and everything. So, football and women, especially in the United States, it's a big thing. So we're definitely thinking on putting some girls and some feminine characters into the clips, definitely.
Thank you.
What will be the name of the female character, if I can say, the girl?
It would be Juana. Yeah.
Try not to make it yellow.
Any question from you, Mohammed?
I think no, that's it.
Any question from someone else? So I think, okay. I think we did it on time. You did really well.
Awesome.
Thank you very much. You made the German happy in me. Thank you very much. Football. So the second pitch is coming from another Spanish-speaking country because it's Spain. So welcome with me on stage the CEO of Joke Film, Joaquin Echeverria, for Mike's Mysteries. Hello.
Hello. Hi. So my name is Joaquin. I represent Joker Films. And we are going to watch Mike's Mysteries, one short episode. Let's take a look. Video, Nicolas, s'il te plaît.
Mike's Mysteries. Where do books come from? Harry Potter is a great movie character, but did you know that his adventures started in books? And where do all these famous stories and movies come from? Let's try and solve the mystery. Yeehaw! In prehistoric times, humans wrote symbols on walls. Hello, miss and sir. Did you know that you're the inventor of comics? Thousands of years later, Egyptians began writing hieroglyphs on papyrus. In China, they invented paper in the 2nd century and started making books. But these books were written by hand, one by one. Don't worry, man. You only have to write like that for the next 1,300 years.
1,300 years?
1,300 years.
1,300 years?
1,300 years.
1,300 years?
1,300 years.
Action, Mike.
And don't forget the question of the day, where do books come from? Well, let's ask my classmate. Hi, where do you think books come from? Books? What are those? Do you mean like a tablet? Join us next time for another story in Mike's Mysteries!
Okay, thank you. So, Mike, the intrepid reporter, travels in his time machine in search of news from centuries past or just a few minutes ago, or news that haven't happened yet, and now we have a surprise. Come on, Mike, please.
Oh.
So, I present Mike. Years and after years, we study all the movement of this guy. And the truth that is a lifesaver, because now we don't have to spend money on making a life-size replica of the character. I'm very pleased to introduce you the artistic director, Jagoba Moli, come from Bilbao. Thank you very much, Jagoba. So, as you can see on screen, Mike's Mystery is 104 episodes at 2 minutes and 30 seconds. The series aimed at a target of age 6 to 9, so we believe that thanks to its aesthetic and sense of humor, it will interest other age groups. Mike's Mystery is fake new reports in a comedic tone with slapsticks and absurd comedy. So, what separates Mike's Mystery from other series on the market? Mike's Mystery is educational content in a package full of humor, short and fun messages. The star is not a child. Younger age groups might identify him as their older brother, cousin. The design, moustache, etc. gives the series a kitsch touch that offers the program a distinct aesthetic to other series created for this age group, along with designs that are clearly for children. Mike's Mystery is a transmedia series developed by my company, Geoca Films. It's a company located in Bilbao, Spain, and French, and we are in Basque Country, which produces programs and formats for TV broadcaster, and we sell licenses for format internationally. And for this series, we work with I Can Fly. I Can Fly is a studio located in France, in Aquitaine, with delegation in Canada and England. It's a company in charge of the series production. Some episodes. So the concept is always one question, and after our character will answer to the question. So for example, why do zebras have stripes? Where do books come from? Who was the first vampire? What came first, the chicken or the egg? Now, the budget is 820,000 euros. The distribution strategy for Mike's Mystery, so it's very important because we have an application to can send question to Mike, and we will answer to the question. And I think that it's okay. Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much. Yeah. I forgot to say that it's on the border of France and Spain, so the accent was French, okay. Not Spanish.
Yeah, it's okay.
Well done. Thank you very much, Joaquin. So, Mike's Mysteries. So, what are the questions from our rich jury?
I just want to know, how do you plan to interact in real time through the social media?
Yeah, so for the social media with the application, in the process of creating the series, we are going to open with our app. We have the app and the website to can send a question to Mike. After, of course, with 104 episodes, it's not possible to answer in 104 episodes. It's more like a game to can be interactive, and after we're going to choose with our script writer and direction team one or two or three questions, and to can after answer with our reporter.
During the show, you mean?
Why?
During the show, you will answer the question during the show.
It will be in the end of the season, of course.
All right.
And the idea is to create a community when we are in the process of production.
Okay.
So there is no real-time engagement with the audience?
Not really. But at the same time, it's. When we have the questions, the idea is to can choose one question and after to can offer in our platform more information and more education about different type of questions.
played simultaneously on TV, and you can use the app during that time, I guess.
So the app would be the digital asset in focus.
It would be interactive. We will receive a different question after, of course, it's not possible technically to answer to all the questions. The idea is to create one community at the same time.
You would be surprised.
Yeah, sure, I hope so, because the children have a lot of questions with why.
No, because we're asking this because we get hundreds and hundreds of questions each post.
Yeah.
We actually do answer most of them, if not all.
Yeah.
So the interesting part for this is that it's interactive. So this is why our questions are focused on that.
Yeah.
Because the children will ask questions. What if they ask, for example, anything outside of... So if they ask, when were the pyramids made, or who made the pyramids, or why, or how?
Yeah.
Would that also be answered, or would that be... How would you harvest information from online or digital, let's say social media, and then from that see what is most interesting and produce other shows?
Yeah, of course. The website, I think that we have to make one real experience to know more our public, to know more our audience. And I think that internet is fantastic for it, because at the same time we can catch all this information and we can think differently. And so that is the first objective of our application, of course, yeah.
There could be a pilot phase, I think, from what I hear, so to see how the reactions are, to trigger the next step. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, thank
you. Last question, Afra, no? Yuko?
I love the concept and how you answered the question. It's really a great idea. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you
that
very
was
much.
Positive.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. So we're moving now to a tiny little country, Russia. Welcome with me the director of sales of Kinoatis, Olga. Oh, I didn't train that one. Olga Kabibulina. Yeah, that's almost there. So thank you, Olga, for being here to pitch Planet I. Thank you, Olga, for being here.
Yeah, thank you. So should I start now? Okay. So I'm here to present Project Planet I, produced by animation studio Kinoatis. It's very well known in Russia. We made first national 3D animation movie, Space Dogs. It was widely released, and then we produced animation TV series, Space Dogs Family. Here we go.
Baba.
Whoever is taking things from Earth has got to be here on the moon.
Wait, stop!
Look over there!
Hello, Houston. I think we've got a bit of a problem.
So there was a small teaser of our second feature, Space Dogs 2. Those two features and series are widely worldwide released. And there are a lot of applications, PC games, video games, DVD release. There are lots of merchandising deals. So that gave us opportunity to become one of the most popular animation brands in Russia. And there are other key achievements. We have over 1 million and 35 million of views on YouTube. We have two successful animation series, three features already, and we are one of the most popular animation series in Russia too. And of course, we have good press coverage. And now to Project Planet I. It's devoted to adventures of small family of aliens. They live carefree and calm on their planet, but everything changes when Daddy's inventor, creates a monitor and it starts transmitting broadcasts from the far away and unknown planet Earth. And Roger, his son, tries to copy everything he sees, and it constantly leads to funny consequences. Those are our posters, and here is our trailer.
Живет в галактике мальчик Роди. Он мит поседа по детской природе. Чтобы унять ребяческий пыл, робота папа ему смастерил. Папа потом изобрел монитор, вроде и робот сломали прибор. Ручку на стромы, как не
пути, твой задний передачи земли. Планета, ай, 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 планета, ай, 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 планета, ай, 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 планета, ай, 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 ай.
Ready. So here was the trailer. And in spite of the fact that TV series is not finished yet, we are planning to make 52 episodes, and we already made 6 pilot series, and we have received great interest from TV channels, top TV channels in Russia, and we are already broadcasting the current episode, and there even was a theatrical release of the series within Project Mult v Kino. And there is character gallery for you just to take a look. It's a funny fidget boy, Rodia. It's daddy. It's their robot housekeeper. Sharpik, their pet, and steel frames. And what makes this project of high international potential? First of all, it's non-dialogue. First, it has funny and gorgeous script, so it's a gag, it's based on comedy, so it's international, it's devoted to space aliens, and there are lots of different sujets, so they see broadcast about some event, maybe New Year, or football, or fishing, and they try to do it and just make something wrong, but it's really funny. And for now, we have a production budget $2.6 million USD dollars, and for now we have $1.3 million USD dollars of our own funds, and we need financing. So we would be great in case you find our project interesting. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So it's our contact. That's it.
Yeah, so karasho and spasiba.
Thank you.
So, and sorry just to say it again quickly, yours. I mean, we'll have a discussion with the five when they deliberate, we'll have a discussion with them. So Q&As, if you want to ask questions. I'll say it again. So it's an alien family watching the Earth and trying to imitate, and that's the gag of it. So I just to say it clearly. So
actually, it's a nice production, and I really like it. But I have to ask you, what is exactly your main message? What do you want to say?
Main message. What do main you want, to, what do you want to tell?
I think that the main message is how important for family to be one piece, and for children to be kind, to learn something, to be curious, not stop learning, and having fun doing this. So it's quite kind of serious, and it learns how to be polite, how to treat your pet, how to be a family. So I guess it's nice because it brings some good positive thinking. And it's funny, of course, because
it's curiosity and family values. Good.
Thank you very much. Just the question that you have is, what is the educational aspect behind the cartoon?
Thank you for your question. It's really good. The educational aspect is that the children have a chance to see something new from each episode. So, for example, there is one episode devoted to some tradition, celebration of New Year, or how to fishing, or how to go camping, or how to, I don't know, build a house. So, and the children see how to do this, and they can try this, and learn something new.
Thank you.
Any digital questions, Ivan?
I think they pretty much asked my questions. But from the point of view of the characters, are there any other ones that you would introduce in the future?
We are planning to add mom to the family, but it will be the big secret.
That's an important person in the family. Yes,
yeah,
mom.
We won't,
yes.
Yeah.
Somehow.
Maybe they will have brother or sister.
I think we all had one, yes. So Yeah, but the aliens, hey, we're laughing, but the aliens, so they could have no mom.
But yeah, we have...
Is the dad the one giving birth maybe on the planet?
Okay, yeah, ooh, maybe. Question. We have a YouTube channel and we receive lots of requests and we are considering them and analyzing them, so why not to add some additional character, maybe cat or something, or brother or sister. It's a nice idea to react on your audience.
So it was a good question from Ivan. So there is a moment she might appear. Good. Olga, it was fabulous.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Спасибо. So we had three. So number four is coming from the UK. It's actually someone who should have been now at a wedding, but is here for you to... Oh, no, sorry, it's the wrong one. So it's good I do a mistake. It's just I got you awake, right? So now it's someone from the UK, but also has a tiny little Russian accent. She's the managing director of Media IM. So welcome for Rosa and Dara Maria Hofland. Thank you. And you're not at a wedding, obviously, Maria. So thank you for being here and joining us.
Good afternoon. We are delighted to be here and thank you very much for the opportunity. I would like to start with the introduction to our wonderful twins, Rosa and Dara.
There was a great adventure awaiting us at Grandma and Grandpa's house. The lost cows were the fault of their dog Laiko, but it's no wonder he got upset when they squashed his car. Saving a bunch of cows all over the world is really fun. But sometimes it's a bit scary too. The rescue mission was amazing. And how did it all turn out? You can find that out in our first adventure.
Some key facts about the production. So it's a fantasy adventure series produced by Czech Republic's Binaut Animation and Credence Film, and we are the distribution partner to those companies. The half an hour TV special has been already produced, and it's launching in cinemas in Czech Republic this fall, followed by premieres on Czech television in November, December. And then production of 52 11-minute series will start from 2016. And we are currently looking for further investment to enable the production. It's quite a unique format. It's a combination of 2D cutout and 3D. And the core audience is kids 6 to 8, but it's actually a perfect show for sibling and parent co-viewing. About the show, in every episode, the sisters come to the grandparents' house and the adventure starts. They come there for the weekend. A granddad is an architect and grandmother is a scientist, she's a genius inventor, and the household is full of wonderful creations and inventions. She's got a space rocket and a flying car, and she also has a dog called Laiko, and Laiko is very much at the center of the stories. In every episode, in the beginning, he creates a problem. The problem's so big that it endangers the whole world, and the girls, along with the grandma, have to solve the problem and rescue the world. The inspiration for the series came from the adventure shows such as Tintin, Duck Stories, DuckTales, Indiana Jones. Most of these adventures, however, had male and boy characters as leads, and that inspired the producers to create the show with female lead characters. However, the stories are quite universal. They would have appealed to both boys and girls, so it's gender neutral. The unique feature, of course, that it also has grandmother very much at the heart of the storylines. Humor is very much part of the series as well. Most of the humor is around the dog called Laiko, He's fun, he's very likable, but he's a troublemaker and he has a lot of flaws, very relatable human flaws, and this is why we love him. We also love him because he can drive a car. These stories have quite a lot of educational elements. In every episode, the girls and the grandmother set on the adventure, and they learn a lot about the world we live in. For example, in the TV special, they travel all over the world in the flying car, and they learn about the moon eclipse. By the way, do you know that they can actually grow bananas in Iceland because of the volcanic heat, or that sequoias are the tallest trees on the planet? So we are constantly learning. The production is planned for 52 episodes to be delivered in two seasons of 26 episodes. The production budget per episode is 35,000, and we're seeking for half of that. Czech Television is co-producing and co-funding the production. And finally, why Rosa and Dara? It has a very unique, distinctive visual look and style. The show that kids would love and parents would absolutely love watching together with their kids. It has a very classic adventure story feel, but also is very modern, very fresh.
And you have to be very quick for the last three.
It's
quick.
Educating through engagement with
quick.
Kids, humor.
Humor. And
very relatable.
Relatable
globally.
Thank
and finally,
you.
Has multi-platform potential through
games,
applications, publishing, electronic books.
Fabulous. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Maria. Beautiful look. Very nice. Very interesting. Yes.
Thank you very much. I like the concept. But do you think that it will attract only the girls? And if you can specify the target audience?
The core audience is 6 to 8. So it's upper preschool or the bridge show. But actually, the adventures are set in a variety of places. And they should attract both girls and boys. So the target audience is not just girls. It would have an appeal to boys as well. And there is a lot of gadgets. There is also a very, you know, inspiring kind of lead character in the face of a grandmother. It's also perfect for sibling co-viewing. All the siblings would watch it. Parents would enjoy watching it with their kids as well. So it's really a family, all-family entertainment show.
You've mentioned games as an extension of the concept. Will they be more focused on educational aspects or adventures?
I think it's an open plan, really. So at the moment, the TV special is produced, and there are a lot of ideas in terms of how the brand can be extended. It certainly would have a very big publishing potential and digital books potential. It can be both educational but also adventurous. The show is not educational per se. It's actually education through engagement, through adventures. So the education comes in a very subtle way without being too patronizing or too into your face. You just learn through adventure.
And the theme song is quite nice. I could buy that as a record, really. It's very beautiful.
Yes, we absolutely love the show. As a distribution partner to Credence Film and Binaut, we love this series from the minute we saw it, and we are very lucky to be partners.
It's a good show. It's a really nice show. It's a quick question. Just how flexible do you think that the cutout animation now it's in regards to the merchandising or licensing in general on a later stage?
I think that the visual style of the show is very unique. It's very much inspired by the tradition of European animation. The studio wants to stay truthful to the look, and the merchandising and auxiliary opportunities will come as supplementary opportunities to the series to match the look and the feel and the style and the concept behind it.
Is there a book already?
No, nothing has been developed apart from the TV specials. There is quite a lot of directions where the project could go.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Okay, and last but not least, is a Danish person here. The Danes say for last but not least, Rosin die Pülsen, which means the last raisin at the end of the sausage. So, the raisin at the end of the sausage should be at a wedding, but is here. So please welcome with me the Managing Director of Fourth Wall Creative, Joe Monroney, for the boy who switched off the sun. Thank you very much for being here.
Hello, thanks for having me. So, Boy Who Switched Off the Sun. This is a TV special which is adapted from a picture book which we published in the UK this year. So I'll just quickly go through the story. So the story is about Marcel, and he absolutely loves ice cream. He loves it so much that he stockpiles it all over his house. But what he really wants to do is enjoy his ice cream on his favourite bench by the beach with his dog Whippy. There he is. But the sun keeps ruining the enjoyment by turning his ice cream into a melting, drippy mess. So Marcel tries lots of different methods to beat the heat of the sun. He tries to eat it too quickly, but that just makes a mess over him and Whippy. He tries to eat it in the dark, but that's just far too scary. So he tries to eat it in the cold, but that just gives him terrible brain freeze. So one day he has an idea that the sun's just like a dazzling light bulb in the sky, so he'll just switch it off. So that's what he does. He sets to work with Whippy. They build a solar-powered rocket, and then they blast off on their way to space and to try and find the off switch. So they finally find it, and they, with a little bit of help from Whippy and a loud clunk, they switch off the sun. They have just enough solar power to get crash land back to Earth, but Marcel goes to bed really excited, and he dreams that he's going to enjoy a nice ice cream on his favorite bench by the beach without the sun ruining his enjoyment. But when he wakes up, he realizes that all's not too well, actually. It's still too dark and scary, and it's still too cold. But worse than that, all the plants are dying and withering, and all the animals are unhappy and in hiding. So he realizes he's made a terrible mistake. So he decides he needs to turn it back on. But he has no solar power in his rocket, so he needs to come up with another solution. And what he does, he uses all of his stockpiled ice cream, and he comes up with an idea that he uses all of his stockpiled ice cream to build a giant catapult and fire it on the sun's on switch. So that's what he does. He builds the biggest scoop the world's ever seen and has one shot at turning it on, at switching it back on. But even though the sun's been switched off, the dying embers still radiate a bit of heat, so the ice cream melts on its way there until all that's left is a tiny scoop of tutti frutti flavour. But it lands a direct hit on the on switch and the sun immediately comes back on. All the plants start opening up again, all the animals come out of hiding, and all the crowds cheer. And Marcel realises that it's actually not too bad to enjoy a nice drippy ice cream on his favourite bench by the beach with his dog Whippy. So that's they're the illustrations from the picture book. I'll just show you the film now to show how we've adapted this for the animation. We can just play the film.
Marcel loves ice cream more than anything else in the world. But this summer, he has a very big problem. The sun. Until he has an amazing idea. Things don't work out quite as he expects.
Storms are raging across the planet. I repeat, the sun has gone out. The entire world is freezing over.
What have I done?
Okay. So the story is about Marcel and Whippy, and while we were working on the special, we realised there was a lot more potential in it. So just quickly going through the future and beyond, we've actually developed a brand of Marcel and a TV-branded series of 26 11-minute episodes. These are all fully developed. I'm short of time, so I can go through these afterwards if anyone was interested. But they're all developed, 26 episodes. We've also considered the sort of licensing and merchandising, so there's some examples there. We've also conceived an app as well, a kids app. So that's a narrative-based app, but it has different levels to unlock and some gameplay as well. So there's Marcel the brand, as well as the TV series. It's bookended by two specials. So we've got The Boy Who Switched Off the Sun. We've also got The Boy Who Unplugged the Sea, which is a book that's coming out next year. And going back to The Boy Who Switched Off the Sun special, because there are wintry scenes and summer scenes in there, it's actually fit for all year round, really, so it's not just for Christmas. So just to recap, We're a multi-award winning IP producer. We have a BAFTA winning studio attached to the project, as well as a BAFTA winning composer. It's a timeless tale with international appeal and the project fully developed. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Just to the dot, yes. So, questions?
It is a quite unique concept. For me, this concept is, I believe the show is about teaching kids the concept of actions and reactions or the consequences of their action. Is this your main focus?
Yes, that's one of them, yeah. Basically, it's tapping into child logic. So kids always have questions, you know, where do clouds come from, things like that. So it's tapping into that mindset and encouraging them to think about the world imaginatively, but also about the consequences to actions as well. So yeah, that is a key point, yeah.
Can you tell us more about how did you get the idea, how the process of the...
It was, we were working on a concept for a picture book, and one of the working titles was The Last Chocolate Biscuit, and basically one of the ideas was about a girl actually wanted to eat a chocolate biscuit in a green treehouse, but the sun was melting the chocolate, and it just quickly, it was a collaborative process, and quickly came about to be ice cream and switching off the sun, so...
Is there going to be a girl who switched off a son?
No. It's just Marcel.
So your target audience is primarily boys?
No. I think I've got my own audience at home. I've got two girls, 7 and 5, and they absolutely love the project. So they love Marcel. I think it does. It is for all because it taps into that child logic. It is suitable for boys and girls, but it also has wider family appeal as well because parents and lots of adults who have seen the project love it as well.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much. So, we let the jury decide, which must be a very difficult decision to do. So, they'll go a few minutes out, and we'll get everyone back here so to discuss a little bit. So, thank you very much again, Mohamed, Afra, and Ivan. And we'll wait for their decision. And so, if you want to come back here, we'll get a few other chairs, yes? It's cool. So I don't know if you have questions. I mean, you can apply next year to get your project here and try to get in. Please step in. Does someone in the audience have a question to one of the shows? So basically, very different shows. We have a football patch, like a little patch of, like a little, okay, it's going to be called the Green SpongeBob now. But and we have the mysteries and the questions from around the world. We have the planet, our world observed by aliens. We have the grandma and the two daughters. Granddaughters, obviously, yes, saving the cows with the naughty dog around. And the beautiful story of the boy who switched off the sun. So this is the five finalists. Were you surprised to get chosen? Like, when did you hear about it? You were going on a wedding, right?
Yeah, I'm supposed to be at a ceremony right now, actually. So we heard about a week ago. So this wedding was already booked about a year ago. So good timing, really.
So surprised or?
Well, a little bit surprised, I think. Delighted.
Did you remember that you applied for that?
Certainly did.
Yes.
And we were only informed last week, so we never expected it.
Speak in the mic. Yeah.
So we only found out last week, so it was a bit of a short notice.
So they all look they all look for money. If someone has a checkbook here on the channel or is a distributor, when you are a distributor, so yes. You've been here 2 or 3 years ago with one of your, and you were in the competition. Did it help to be here?
Definitely. Like, it was our first MIP when we came here for the International Pitch Contest, and we met a lot of people. I mean, it was like opening the door to a whole new world.
And you moved on further with your project publishing and now trying to finalize it, okay?
Yes, exactly. With the project we brought to the Pitch Contest, we recently got an offer to publish it as a graphic novel. So it's going a different direction, but I guess it was always planned to be a brand.
Yes, hallelujah. I have a lot of questions, but yes.
I have a question for John. Joe, sorry. Really like the look and feel of your show. Just kind of interested, who's your publisher? Do you self-publish? Did you find a publisher? And how important was it for them to know that it was going to be developed into a series and have a broadcaster on board?
We are the publisher, so we have our own publishing division. So we publish, it actually publishes this month. So we always had the intention of exploring the animation, the film side of rights to all of our books. So that was always on the radar, really. But yeah, no, we publish ourselves under our own publishing division.
Okay, thanks.
That's a good question. I mean, developing takes forever, and doing the book in the meantime and making it successful helps usually. So it should also be a book, I think.
Absolutely. I think this project would be beautiful, visually stunning, and would work really well.
Question to Russia or to Mexico? Yeah. Yes, darling, you get a mic here.
Thank you. In deciding the look of your shows, what went into consideration? How did you decide which form to use, and that process, if you could share?
Quick words from each. So, Joe.
We always wanted it to look the 3D style and be really filmic with great lighting, things like that. We thought that the actual storyline went beyond the pages of the picture book, so we always saw it in a real sort of high-end finish, really very filmic and dramatic to match the story.
Joaquin, quick one. The look? No. His look is obvious. Pff, it's French. You answer, pff, when you're in France, pff, yes. Sorry, shouldn't say that, darling. It's Basque, it's not French. Yes.
For our look, I guess we were looking to do it 3D, but we also wanted all that richness the 2D gives, especially for the facial animation. So we decided to do a mashup, right, with 3D and 2D.
There was a long way for us because we had used to have a 2D department, but we made Space Dogs in 2D, and then we had a proposal to make it 3D, and we accepted, and it was the first movie. And then we made the second, and the small secret of this movie is the family of aliens appears in the feature, and it was so likable, so we decided to make a spin-off, so there was no question in what format to do. It was already 3D.
Well, on behalf of the studio who produced it, I'll say that they wanted to stay true to the tradition of classical animation, 2D animation, and yet they wanted to make it very contemporary, very modern. So that's how the idea of combining 2D and 3D and using the cutout came, making the show quite unique and standing out.
Fine, very distinctive look, by the way. Oh, very good. Yeah, you want to say something now? No, you're still happy? Yeah, good. You can also pitch your show if you quickly want to say who you are and say what your shows you've got here. You can do that here. It's allowed. I hope they're coming soon back because I didn't have my dessert and I missed some coffee. So as a former broadcaster, yeah, I would take all the shows, obviously. Yes, one question here. Yes.
No, you said we had an opportunity to pitch.
Sure.
So.
Well, quick. Grab it, darling.
Well, and I'm tired.
One short sentence.
The Curious Cubs Club chronicles the life of four spirited six-year-old bear cub detectives who use teamwork and their science know-how to solve mysteries in nursery rhymes and fairy tales.
Cool. Bears, yee-haw, well done. Okay. Okay, I wish you luck for being here at the competition next year. So, okay, now we'll have the jury coming back. So let me introduce first to announce them, Laurine Garraud, who's the director of TV division of Read Me Dem. So thank you very much for being here and hosting us.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. First, I'd like to say all the five projects were really great. And thank you to all the finalists for their presentations. Thank you very much. Big thank you to Majid Entertainment, our sponsor today. and to the jury. So, Mohammed.
In the next three years, you have a check for the next 3 years, darling. They didn't say how much you can now negotiate. We'll you say you want a million later. Per year. Yes.
But anyway, I want to thank them. I wasn't thinking money. I want to thank Majid Entertainment, Mohammed, Ivan, and Afra, the jury, and you, Christophe, for being our host and partner for many years now. So now let's find out who won.
Thank you very much. So please come back. Please
join us.
Come back, everyone, from Majid, yes.
And?
There'll be pictures at the end.
Just
so this
I
is very, very...
Christophe is the star of tonight.
No. You got it wrong. I have no money, darling. I'm a farmer. I'm a former broadcaster. I have a big mouth. So they're all very excited, and they want to know.
We want to take this opportunity first to thank all the participant members and producers of this year's MIPJunior International Pitch. I've contributed and showcased some phenomenal ideas. Honestly, it's a very hard decision, but at the end there is one winner. And I think the winner of the MIPJunior International Pitch for the 2015 is the boy who switched off the sun.
Congratulations. Thank you very much for everyone for attending. Yes, goal in the picture. Remember, who's got the money here? It's called Mohammed from Majid. And congratulations for the winner, for all the other contestants, please, because they put a lot of effort to come here and pitch. So for the four others, please, now your applause for the four other contestants. And we hope to see some of you here with your projects next year. Thank you very much. Dankeschön. Merci. Thank you.